Good morning and welcome to this act of remembrance. This year, perhaps more than any other, we understand the importance of sacrifice, of self-giving, and of community. And this morning we're here to remember people who have made the ultimate sacrifice of giving their lives for others. Welcome to our Remembrance Day service. Before we start, I would just like to offer my thanks for all the people who have made this service possible. Thanks to the chaplain, who will be leading the rest of the service, to Becca Nichols and to Hope Whitehead for all the IT support, to our wonderful choir and to all of our students who have read the names of those who we remember.
They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them.
Thank you. The reading is taken from the Gospel of St. John, chapter 15. As the Father hath loved me, so have I loved you. Continue ye in my love. If ye keep my commandments, ye shall abide in my love. Even as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. These things have I spoken unto you, that my joy might remain in you, and that your joy might be full. This is my commandment, that ye love one another, as I have loved you. Greater love hath no man than this, than a man lay down his life for his friends. Ye are my friends, if ye do whatsoever I command you. Henceforth I call you not servants, for the servant knoweth not what his Lord doeth, but I have called you friends. For all things that I have heard of my Father, I have made known unto you. Ye have not chosen me, but I have chosen you, and ordained you, that ye should go and bring forth fruit, and that your fruit should remain, that whatsoever ye shall ask of the Father in my name, he may give it to you. These things I command you, that ye love one another. Here endeth the reading.
Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. May I speak in the name of God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. These words of Christ are those by which we are bidden today's act of remembrance. This is a particularly important year to remember the sacrifice of those who have given their lives for us, scattered as we are and cut off from one another. To remember is to bring to one's mind an awareness of something or someone, literally to recall. And that recalling has a connotation of regathering, recrafting, recreating a body of humanity of which we are all members. To remember is to bring a body back together, scattered as it is across continents and islands, across foreign fields and on other shores. As we remember the sacrificial love of those who have given their lives for us, we recognize that we are all bound together by their gift and memory. In this act, as we lament the sins that divide us, we remember, we bring ourselves back together as a corporate whole. Remembrance Sunday isn't about celebrating war or division, but about cultivating a future reality in which we are unified and at peace. Each Sunday is, of course, for us, a remembrance of the greatest sacrifice made once for all, Christ dying upon the cross. His death and resurrection gives us the ultimate freedom from sin and death and unites us with him and the Father. Even though we find ourselves separated in this moment, it's in this act that we can rejoin together, that we call to mind the sacrifice of the fallen and seek to build a future worthy of their offering. Make sure not to let this moment, their memory, slip by unnoticed and uncounted. And holding on to that example, turn your mind to building a better world. Amen.
January 1944, Lieutenant Randall Connett Price, 7th Battalion Gloucestershire Regiment, member of 12 Commando, fell ill whilst on active service and died in Wrexham Emergency Hospital, aged 21. Captain Martin Hawken, 10th Battalion, 19th Hyderabad Regiment, Delhi, India, aged 30. Lieutenant John Ashby, Royal Artillery, Royal North Devon Field Regiment, Caserta, Italy, aged 20.
February 1944. Lieutenant Ian Adamson, Royal Navy, of the light cruiser HMS Uganda, of illness in Charleston Hospital, South Carolina, age 25. Captain Anthony Eyre, Royal Artillery, 44th LA Regiment, Rangoon, Burma, age 24. Captain John Hanford, Royal Artillery, fell ill whilst on active service and died in Porth, aged 51.
March 1944. Lance Corporal George Good, Intelligence Corps, 91 Port Security Section, Liverpool, fell ill whilst on active service in Italy and died in Broadgreen Emergency Hospital, Liverpool, aged 24. Squadron Leader Peter Carpenter, RAF 51 Squadron, Coastal Command. Flying a Ventura from RAF Skilton on a meteorological flight, aged 25.
April 1944, Lieutenant John Black, 2nd Battalion, Wiltshire Regiment, Anzio, Italy, aged 27. Major William Towle, Royal Engineers, attached 68 Field Company, Royal Indian Engineers. Impal, Burma Front, aged 27.
June 1944, Major John Jarmaine, Royal Artillery, 193rd Battery, Anti-Tank Regiment, Royalville, Normandy Beaches, aged 33.
July 1944, Leading Aircraftman Ambrose Goddard, RAFVR, Metis Beach, Canada, aged 19. Flying Officer Peter McIntosh, RAFVR, 207 Squadron, Bomber Command, flying a Lancaster, returning from a raid over Donge, France, from RAF Spilsby, aged 20.
August 1944. Lieutenant Gavin Galbraith, Royal Engineers, 275 Field Company, Douvres, near Caen, Normandy, aged 21. Captain Anthony Herbert, Royal Engineers, near Caen, Normandy, aged 26.
September 1944, Trooper Roger Rawlance, Royal Horse Guards, near Amiens, France, aged 24. Lieutenant Donald Creighton, MC, 11th Hussars, Royal Armoured Corps, Croisette, France, aged 23. Gunner Samuel Hetherington, Royal Artillery, 86th Medium Regiment, Nieuwen, Belgium, aged 22. Captain John Henry, 10th Battalion Parachute Regiment, Army Air Corps, Arnhem, Holland, aged 23. Flying Officer John Garvey, RAFVR, 48th Squadron, Transport Command flying a Dakota from RAF Down Ampney, Arnhem Campaign, aged 21. Captain Kenneth Dimmer, South Staff Regiment, attached 6th Battalion Green Howards, Arnhem Holland, aged 24.
October 1944, Lieutenant Reginald Woods, Parachute Regiment, Army Air Corps, Hanover, Germany, aged 25.
Sergeant Lawrence Hyde, RAFVR, 70th Squadron, flying a Wellington from Cerignola, Italy, age 20.
December 1944, Flying Officer Martin Bottomley, RAFVR, Navigator, killed in a flying accident, Nicosia, Cyprus, age 22. Major Alfred Hesketh Pritchard, MC, Royal Fusiliers, City of London Regiment, attached to the Special Operations Executive, in Southern Austria, aged 28. Flying Officer Henry Medrington, RAFVR, 57 Squadron, Bomber Command, flying a Lancaster over Munich from RAF East Kirkby, aged 21.
January 1945, Lieutenant Eric Gardner, Royal Corps of Signals, Eindhoven, Holland, aged 21. Lieutenant Brian Byrne, 2nd Battalion, East Lancashire Regiment, near Rangoon, Burma, aged 23.
February 1945, Lieutenant Kenneth Jevons, Royal Artillery, 77 Light Anti-Aircraft Regiment, died of wounds near Rangoon, aged 24. Lieutenant Andrew Murdoch, Royal Engineers, attached Field Company Royal Indian Engineers, near Rangoon, aged 22. Acting Sub-Lieutenant Anthony Fahey, RNVR, on board the corvette HMS Bluebell, torpedoed in the Arctic off of Russia, aged 19.
March 1945, Lieutenant Peter Collins, MC, Royal Marines, 48 Commando, Bergen op Zoom, Holland, aged 24. Lieutenant Maurice Hammond, Royal Engineers, died of malaria near Rangoon, Burma, aged 21.
April 1945, Flight Lieutenant Maurice Matthias, RAFVR, 112 Squadron, Fighter Command, flying a Mustang from Cervia, Italy, over Austria, aged 28. Lieutenant William Hogg, Irish Guards, near Hanover, Germany, aged 25.
The memorial includes the names of three civilians whose exact date of death is unknown. John Sloan, thought to have died in an air raid in 1940, aged about 27. Sui Cheng Lu, a Singaporean civilian who died sometime during the Japanese occupation of Singapore, aged about 28. Eng Ang Tan, a Singaporean civilian who died sometime during the Japanese occupation of Singapore, aged about 24.
A number of men who died after the war, either in accidents or of disease on active service, or as a result of wounds, are included in the memorial. In 1945, Flight Lieutenant Jeffrey Edwards, RAFVR, Jakarta, Indonesia, aged 22. Lieutenant John Sayers, Royal Engineers, attached 71st Field Company, Indian Engineers, killed by an Indonesian nationalist, Jakarta, Indonesia, aged 21. In 1946, Lieutenant Jeffrey Hobson, Intelligence Corps, fell ill whilst on active service and died in the Radcliffe Infirmary, Oxford, aged 26. Air Commodore Edward Hopkins, RAF, aged 42. Sub-Lieutenant Napier Whitcroft, RM, Fleet Air Arm, flying a Spitfire in Northern Ireland, aged 21.
In 1947, Flying Officer John Herrington, RAF, VR, 85 Squadron, Fighter Command, flying a Mosquito from RAF Westmalling, aged 23. Pilot Officer Kenneth Turner, RAF, VR, 286 Squadron, RAF Regiment, killed in a flying accident, Munster, Germany, aged 21. 1948, Flying Officer Neville Cornwall, RAF, killed in a flying accident off Gozo, Malta, aged 22.
In 1949, the Reverend George Boddy, Chaplain to the Armed Forces, age 56.
Thank you.
The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit rest upon you, upon your families and homes, this day and forevermore. Amen.